Hello everyone, welcome to another Corbett Gaming Achievement Walkthrough. This is Life Expectancy, bringing you Limbo for the Xbox One, although this is identical across platforms, so this will work great for the Xbox 360, PS3, PS4, whatever you're playing on. This is 100% walkthrough, all achievements in one run, including the achievement for dying 5 times or less in a single playthrough. I've edited out my deaths in this one, but I believe I only died 3 times in this particular run. Just a couple of really silly mistakes on super easy parts, and then one death at the very end, which I think I might have actually left that last one in. I'm not quite sure at the moment if I left that last final death at the very end of the game in the video. It's quite common for just about everyone to die at least once right there at the very end on the gravity puzzles. So what I've done here is I've sped up the gameplay to 1.5 times normal speed just to make the video a little shorter. Like I've said before, I like my videos, especially these long play videos for these shorter games, to be nice and tight and concise so that you don't have to fast forward quite as much if you're looking for a specific part. I will have timestamps down in the description below if you're interested in skipping forward to one of the 10 Easter eggs. This game only has an achievement for finishing the game, an achievement for each of the 10 Easter eggs, and then the achievement for finishing the game with 5 or fewer deaths, and finally the achievement for finishing the secret level. And in order to play the secret level, you have to get all 10 Easter eggs and complete the game at least once, although not necessarily in that order. If you miss an egg, you can go back and get it. I have confirmed this. All you have to do is go back and get the one you missed, and then keep playing until you reach the next checkpoint, you know, the next chapter cutoff, which, you know, they're super short, so it's not a problem, in order to have that Easter egg saved. I'm not sure if they save. I didn't check to see if you just grab it and then immediately quit out to the main menu, if that registers. But it's not that hard to just grab an egg that you've missed and then, you know, play another 30 seconds into the game to get to the next part. Just to make sure it saves. But that's really all you have to do if you need to go back and get one or two that you miss. It's a fantastic game. I would highly advise, once again, like with my unmechanical walkthrough, I would advise playing through it once without any walkthroughs of any kind. Just enjoy the game, you know, enjoy the puzzles. It's really great. It's a lot of fun. And then once you've done that, because you need a little bit of practice anyway to do your 5 or fewer deaths run. So play through the game, enjoy it, and then maybe just load up the specific chapters you need for the Easter eggs, grab those, and then, you know, do the 5 or fewer deaths run after that once you're a little practiced. And other than that, yeah, it's a great game. Hope you guys enjoy it. Hope you enjoy the walkthrough. And I will have a little bit more commentary at the beginning of the secret level, followed by just some text prompts during the secret level, because that one is very much an auditory cues level. So yeah, hope you enjoy the video and have yourselves an awesome day. Thanks. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, and here we have the bonus chapter, the secret level. So what you're going to want to do is load up level 26, climb down the ladder right here at the start, and then go over to the right. And if you've gotten all 10 Easter eggs and completed the game, then the bonus level will be open. I won't be doing voice narrations because it is crucial to hear things, as there are several places in the secret level where you have to listen for certain sound effects to dodge blades or get a parasite removed. So with that, I'll leave you with the secret level. And there you have it, folks. That's the end of the secret level, and the final achievement is unlocking right about now, and that gives you the full 1,000 gamer score in Limbo, or 400 if you're on the Xbox 360. I think it's 400 in one playthrough. As always, if you enjoy these videos, please like, comment, and subscribe, and have yourselves a wonderful day.